Icing is very dangerous to aircraft in flight. Mixed ice, which has the worst characteristics of both rime ice and clear ice, can build quickly. Let's take a look. Ice sticks first to surfaces with a small curvature radius. Things with large curvatures, like windscreens, accumulate ice the slowest, since they push the airflow with moisture around and away from their curved surface. Our animation isn't perfect, but it shows the effect of ice on an airframe. On the propeller, ice creates an imbalance and decreased thrust. On the cowling, ice blocks air inlets, preventing engine cooling or blocking air intakes. On the windscreen, ice limits visibility. On the antennas, ice can break them off or hamper navigation and communication. Aerodynamically, ice alters laminar airflow and decreases lift. See how the blue lines begin to curl, representing the eddies of disrupted laminar flow? By pitching up to stay level, the situation becomes worse, as more surface area is exposed to the accumulation of ice weight and additional drag. The pilot, now flying slower, is spending more time in this harmful environment. Ice ruins lift, adds weight, adds drag, decreases visibility, can harm engine and propeller performance, and can impact communications. Even de-icing equipment on an aircraft can fail or be overwhelmed by too much ice. There are two solutions. Don't enter known icing environments, and if ice is encountered, take prompt action to get out of that icing environment by climbing, turning, or descending to reach warmer air. Ice encounters must be dealt with quickly before they become a potentially fatal problem. To see the full animation and training, get the IFR Pilot Virtual Test Prep DVD at www.asatofly.com. You can see other short flight animations by Googling Robert Bremmer, Cloud School. Thanks for watching.